Thank you. जय गोपाल केशव माधव दीन दयाल।
जय गोविंद जय गोपाल केशव माधव दीन दयाल।
जय गोविंद जय गोपाल केशव माधव दीन दयाल।
जय गोविंद Bye.
first should be so pleasant. That should be cuckoo bird, peacocks, deers, and plenty of grasses for cows. Upanand told that Maharaj Shandil Rishi is here. He knows everything, loop and corner of all the Vrindavan. And I also have some experience. So we can go to Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, oh Govardhan, he is so pleasant, so pleasant. Oh, very water flow are there. River is there. So beautiful Manshi Ganga is there. And all the things for playing Krishna is there. Plenty of
grass
is there. So, and also in Vrindavan, there are so many banyan trees, peepal trees, so many forests of kadamba, tamal, so much deers there. Water of Jamuna is so lovely. So we should go there. At last they decided to go there. Anand Baba Ghoshana ki announced on drum by his any servant that tomorrow in very morning about 4-5 or all cows should be directed towards Vrindavan, crossing Jamuna river nearby. All wealth should be taken on bullock cords. The old person, father and mothers and others, they should go on cards. Also the very little boys, they should go on card. And rest, they will follow cows. They should quick march from here. So Krishna and Baldev were sitting on a cart, very big cart, with Krishna and Baldev with mother Rani and Yashoda, and other children were with their mothers, old persons were with bullock. First of all the cowherd, young persons, they were going with, they marched with cows. Cows were like endless ocean. And there were some streams of black cows and white cows. So beautiful the scenery was. And miles over miles, all were marching in a very pleasant way. They made a pool of, they made a boat, so many boats, with banyan trees, keeping so many branches of trees on them, very tightly binded, and thousands, lakhs and lakhs gopis and gopis. They crossed through these boats and bullock cart. They marched in the water. All the cows crossed by
swimming.
Little is cows with their mother, of very pleasant, quickly jumping and crossing. It was a very pleasant scenery. Very pleasant. they took their morning breakfast on the bank of Jamuna River and took some rest and then quickly marched towards Chatti Karal ground. Now Chatti Karal is situated on the north side of Vrindavan. North or west?
North west.
Side of east. West and north. West side of.
East.
Thousands and lakhs of bullock carts were kept like half moon way. And after that, thrones were given that no one can pass in that village and make their huts there under their bullock carts. Their houses were in the bullock and within under bullock carts. And there was made a goshala,
council
out of the village. When Krishna was coming from Jamuna bank on the bullock cart, Krishna was asking, Mother, oh, he is standing and always trembling. You know? Who does?
People
tree, always trembling. His lips always dancing. Who is that person having so much beard, so long, long beard, black beard? Who?
Then
Mother told you he is not a person, he is a tree. His name is?
Banyan
tree. Oh, I see. Oh, too hot, with two horns, jumping berries. And very much, and very beautiful, like golden collar. Who is that? Deer. So Krishna is learning the names, and he is Yashoda Maiya was teaching that. Because boys have some tendency to know what is this, what is this, what is this, how happened. So, Yashodama is teaching and he is learning. Thus they came to new villages. Krishna with Baldev Prabhu was very happy to be in this new village. Nearby Jamuna River, nearby Govardhan Hill, so many good ponds. There was a very big and very pleasant Madhuban, that Madhu honey was there so much. So many things were there. Krishna began to play there. He left Gokul at the age of 3.5 from Gokul. Now he became at the age of about 5 or 4. And he was taking so much butter, ghee, rabadi. So in his voyage, he was so smart and so strong, Krishna and Baldev. They used to wrestle. They used to do vyamana,
exercises.
Jumping here, playing with monkeys. If a monkey is on the tree and his tail is hanging, Krishna Baldev easily used to jump and then monkeys jumping from one tree to the other, and they also jumping from. Sometimes they play a play of
Madak,
Madak, frog.
Leapfrog.
Huh?
Leapfrog.
Jumping. Living like frogs.
Leapfrog.
Living like this. Sometimes they used to dance like peacocks. Sometimes they used to do so many plays. Now, Krishna told his father and mother, "Mother, I am now so strong and I want to go to grace cows." Hearing this, Yashoda became so very. No, why you are so orphaned?
Yeah,
it's
a small
boy. You can. Mother, I should go. Because this is our Vanshkramse.
This is our tradition.
Our tradition. We should go. And he was so jiddy.
Obstinate.
What is the meaning of obstinate?
Stubborn.
Oh, I must go, my mother, I must go. Then anyhow, priest was called, and an auspicious day was seen, and that was Gopashtami. Nand Baba, Gopananda and all the superior gops, they decided that Krishna is so small, so this with children nearby places, they should go to graze small calves, not with calves. Krishna was happy, and thus Yashoda decorated him in a spacious coach and brought some shoes and umbrella for Krishna. So God was worshipped, Nrisimhadeva was worshipped, Shalagrama was worshipped in auspicious day. But Yashoda Mama was decorating Krishna so much, decorating Krishna, and he never wanted that he should go, so he was decorating. And the auspicious time was going on, passing. So priest wanted that Krishna should go and we should have so many cows in
Indonesia.
So they making quickly. But Yashoda wanted to give shoes for Krishna and Baldev and umbrella. Krishna told mother, cows are our superior and worshipable. You should try to give one umbrella and one four shoes for our cows. And then we will supply. And we will
make them wear shoes.
And
umbrella,
and then we will take it. Otherwise, we will not take it. Why? Because Krishna wanted to touch all the earth everywhere with his feet, so that it should be so much auspicious. Earth wanted to take Krishna's feet on her breast. Everywhere the breast of earth is everywhere, like mountains. So she always wanted that Krishna should keep feet on her. That is why Krishna never took umbrella or any shoe. Then after giving donation, cows so many, Krishna began to go towards forest with so many cows. Oh, beautiful cows. some small, some bigger, but all within 1 year. Some men were only 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, like this. She cops and boy cops, both were there. But Yashoda wanted to always keep, embrace Krishna. So she was not leaving. Though Krishna and Baldev with his friends, Dham, Shidham, Subalmad, Mangal and all, he came out of the village, Nandagaon or Vrindavan, Chhattikar. But Yashoda was not in a mood to give up Krishna. So Krishna is telling mother, you should return, you should return, you should return. And she is returning, and again Krishna went, goes 1-2 steps forward to Sarama, again weeping like cows for their calves. Again. At last Krishna told that my bow of my head, you should return. Then Yashoda stopped. Then Nanda Baba and other folks were coming. Anyhow, Krishna stopped them also. There were so many gopis, friends gopi. Aged what? 4, 3, 5. They were also worshipping Krishna with their crooked eyes. And Krishna was accepting Krishna with his eyes. They went to meet with Krishna, sitting on the side of what?
Rooftop.
Balcony. From doors, from
windows.
Some came out of their houses. Standing on the
courtyard.
Krishna beautiful, decorated with peacock feather. Also good kasturi, bansi. Kasturi tilakam lalat patale vastakshale kausubham nakshatre mauktikam. Here. Oh, what jewels here. Hira. Hira means? So, brightly
glittering.
Oh, these kuntals, very good. All with kissing
Krishna.
And so good.
Tilaka
and like
Alka.
You know Alka in this country. Like this, Chandan Bindu. Chandan means? Not only sandal. Kumkum, Kasturi, Karpur and all. Oh, very fast. Fragrant and also so, making so much Shita.
Cool.
Like here, like Makari.
Like fish.
Not fish. Like, you know, spiders.
Cobwebs.
Like this. Very beautiful looking Krishna. And Kasturi Tilakam. Here Kasturi Tilakam. So beautiful. So anyone then wanted to return. Especially gopis. But Hari Krishna told them repeatedly that you should now return. I'm not going far away. I'm very far, very near. I will return with God. So they became like faint, or weeping, or and they stood there. At last, Krishna entered in the forest. He was not seen. And then they were seeing what? Dust in the sky. And when it was also subside, then anyhow, Nanda Baba, Yashoda, and others, they Anyhow, they took return back to all of us. So this, then Krishna went to forest, very nearby. After some days, he was going and doing. One day, with Baladev and others, he was in Cops. In the meantime, a demon in the shape of Cuff, he came. He was somewhat very
strong.
And some bad fragrance was coming because they used to take opium, you know, flesh, meat, eggs, and bad things. Opium, you know? And all the bad things, especially made with meat and other things. Also wine. So bad smell was coming from his nose and mouth. And yet it was very severe. So all the cops, when he used to come to them and wanted to mix with them, all the general cops, taking their towels hard as their own, they used to
jump
and to go towards Krishna and Baladev, fearing. So Krishna was looking towards Baladev. What is happening? Today I am seeing that all the cops are fearing, and this beautiful, but this very strong, this new cops I am seeing. Baladev told by his eyes, not by words. Yes, there is something we should be careful. And then he wanted to come gradually nearby Krishna and to kill Krishna and then to Baladev. But at once Krishna caught hold his left, his
hind
legs, and did like this. And he fell down on the tree. When Krishna followed and he was running to escape, this forest was called Khadiravan, you know. We have done there.
Khadiravan.
There are many places to fall. And thus he was killed. Also, you know that after some days there was a very weak Bakasu. What means?
Crane.
Oh, very bad. And he gave up his lower
beak
on the earth, our next upper side, he took on the sky. And he went out to follow Krishna. Krishna wanted to be careful, but he at once came. At first he was in trance, like yogis, standing on one leg, nearby any water
pond,
nearby Jamuna. And he went there to swallow Krishna. And then he quickly picked up Krishna. And Krishna became like Oh, hot iron.
Bob.
So could not keep in his. So he
vomited.
Again he wanted to attack. Then Krishna quickly put his leg, one leg on the his lower beak, and with hand, oh, he did that. And he was divided into two, and thus he was killed. These two demons were the embodiment of kapatata,
duplicity,
and hypocrisy. You know hypocrisy?
Yes.
Very well. Nowadays, there are so many Bakasur. At the time of Krishna, only one Bakasur was there. But nowadays, we cannot count so many Bakasur. What is Bakasur? Embodiment of hypocrisy, duplicity, and all. Those who have taken initiation, and those who are chanting her name, putting tilak and kanthi mala and all. But they are very tricky. They they play hypocrisy and duplicity. Outer like friend and inner like shatru,
enemy.
Outside like very sweet words, and inner part having a knife. So Krishna can recognize this and he can destroy them. And we see that they are falling down very quickly. If anyone is chanting Hari name and hearing Katha and he is associated, he should be very far away from all these things. But if chanting, remembering and doing Vaishnava, being Vaishnava, they are very much attached to wealth, reputation and followers also, and wives also, children also, so much attachment. They are all duplicitous. Those who play duplicity, always criticizing Vaishnavas, offending Vaishnavas for very short, any very little. They are more offenders. They are actually not Vaishnava. But to be attached, also this is not good. We should do Krishna Sansar. Krishna Sansar, you know? Making Krishna center and thinking that my wife is beloved of Krishna, my husband is beloved of Krishna, my children are servant of Krishna. Thus, this is Krishna sansar. We should support and nourish this and make all the servant of Krishna. And thus, we should associate all with Vaishnavas. And whatever we do, do for Krishna. And remnant should be given to all. This is Krishna Sansar. It can be done. It is allowed. Like all the gopis were family. Also, so many devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, associates, were like householders. Also Pandavas were householders. So if we are householder, then not so much attached. But for Krishna we can do all these things. Because we cannot be so much renounced order person. So we can gracefully do like this. And when we will come at the age of 50, 60, gradually we should give up all these things. Giving all this to our sons and son's wife, and sometimes we Banprasthi, and after that, in Banprasthi, you can live with your wife, no harm. But after some time, you should give your wife also to your sons and be pakka renounced and do that. Like Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Like Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So, this family man, our family life is not bad. We can learn so many things in family life. This is also a perverted reflection of that word. Like a ladder, we can go gradually up by this. But where that family life is not like a ladder, not like a school,
training.
Only for training,
center.
Then it is very bad thing. This would be a training school like this. How to love Krishna? Oh, I should love like my son. I should love Krishna like my husband, more than husband. Like beloved, like friend. So this is like a training school. And those who have tested all these things in previous past lives, they have an impression of all that. So they will not do householder life. And those, they pretend to be brahmacharis, but actually not brahmachari. Oh, after some time they will fade out. Even they are taking sannyas, renounced order, and preaching in the whole world. But quickly from inside they are so much attracted to ladies and girls and wealth. So they were never qualified for this renounced order. But they
pretended
for wealth and reputation they did. But Guru should not give sannyas to them. So there are so many things. These are all those who are not following all these things, they are bakasura. So we should try to be careful from bakasura. You cannot kill bakasura yourself. Who will kill? Oh, Krishna. He can kill. Baldev can kill. So one day, the worker is grazing cows and they went to Madhuban, Talman. You know Talman? All the boys were very thirsty and very hungry. What became? Govindabhag commanded. Tell me where? Then
I don't know the story so well.
Oh?
I don't know the story so well.
I have told so many times. And if you not remember, I will remember you by twisting your ears. Very quickly you will remember.
Before was Vaisasura, Agasura,
Vakasura. Yes,
before was
Vasa Sura, Adha Sura.
Then you can tell Agassi about Agassi.
Great, great.
So shortly after, Krishna had killed Bakasura. He and the cowherd boys, they went. Again, they were taking care of the calves. They were still under the age of 5 years. And Putana and Bakasura, they had a younger brother. They had a younger brother.
Putana, one sister and two brothers. Bakasura and Agasura. One of them, Bakasur, was killed, now Agasur. And he became so
So Agasur was very angry that his older brother and sister had been killed. And again being instigated by Kamsa.
And he promised Kamsa,
I accepted revenge.
I will take revenge and I will kill surely Kamsa.
So then he again is under the influence of Yogamaya. He was able to enter into Vrindavan. And he came in the form of a serpent, but not just an ordinary serpent. He also was a great mystic yogi.
Python?
Python.
A python, particular type of snake, a python. And he expanded his body 8 miles long, explained. And he went on the path, and then with this expanded body, he opened his mouth with his lower jaw on the ground, and just as Bakasura had previously opened his mouth and the beak was right to the sky, so similarly, Agasura opened his mouth in such a way that his upper jaw was up in the clouds, practically was touching the sky. So the cowherd boys, they were playing. And then as he opened his mouth, then from within, a very foul smell was emanating from within his intestines, a very fishy smell. Let's explain.
All the cowherd boys began to tell, oh, what is this?
So then the cowherd boys, they seen this big structure. Then looking at each other, they're saying, oh, what is this? And they thought,
this is like a mountain.
At first they thought, oh, this looks like a very, very big mountain, which is going right up to the sky. Then on close examination, then they saw that, no, this is not a mountain, but this is a huge snake. And
cave.
They saw that this is a cave.
Above that mountain. Mouth was like a cave.
The entrance to the cave.
Excuse me?
The mountain was like a cave.
That's it. He's so eager.
So then they thought it was a cave, but then upon closer, the entrance looking like a cave, then closer examination, then they saw that actually this was a big snake.
No. Oh, they were saying that a very red carpet was.
So then they saw that the entrance, oh, that there's this.
We should go whether a serpent or mountain cave, no harm. Oh, Krishna is there, he's coming behind. Oh, he must save us. They should tell anything. You are very eager. At once come.
I can do a bit more.
No. Go on.
No. So, okay, third time looking. So then they they proceeded very confidently walking into the mouth of Agasura, because they had the confidence that Krishna was with them, and that whatever would happen, that Krishna would protect them.
And what Krishna was doing?
Krishna was scratching his head. Huh? He was wondering, what is going on here?
He was in the last row.
Yes, he was behind, but he did not go in with them. He stayed outside, and he was looking at this.
Why are they going? I cannot serve them. And they are entered. And he was
fixing it.
What to do? Then they will.
So, Agasura, even though all the cowherd boys had walked in, actually it's explained that Krishna, he was looking in amazement also, that how Maya, the material energy, Mahamaya, could manifest such a wonderful thing as this big snake. So the cowherd boys, they walked in, but Agasura was not satisfied, because actually he wanted Krishna. So then finally, Krishna also, then he followed the cowherd boys, and then he walked into the mouth of the big serpent. Then the serpent, being satisfied that Krishna was within, then he closed his jaws. And within the mouth of the serpent, then the cowherd boys, actually they fainted.
All the cows also went.
All the young calves, which the cowherd boys had been taken care of, they also went into the mouth of Agasura, and they all fainted, and then
in the stomach.
तो तुम मुख में जाने से तो पेट में चलेगा बाकी क्या रहेगा
So then Agasura, having Krishna and the cowherd boys, cows within his mouth, then he wanted to devour all of them. But then Krishna, he became very, very hot.
Where?
Within his jaw.
No.
No. Within his throat. That's what I meant, within the throat.
Then he could not break outside. And fall, like fire.
So Agasura could not breathe. He was choking.
And then what he was doing? He was doing chat-pat-chat-pat.
Crashing.
No.
So then Agasura was fighting, becoming restless, moving his head left and right, trying to get rid of this. He wanted to vomit. Vomit out, just as Bakasura previously had vomited, but this time Krishna would not allow. And Krishna just got hotter and hotter and hotter, and the heat increased so much within the head of Agasura. His head was about to burst.
Eyes came.
And then his eyes, like big rasgullas, they went. They busted out. So.
And began to roll down.
And then Agasura, the big serpent, just started to roll, squiggling all over the place. And then the heat, and then finally Krishna, then the light air of Agasura just could not take the intense pain and heat, and just busted out through hole in this skull. So then his mouth opened, because
no, not open.
His Atma came out and was hovering in the sky. Meanwhile, all the demigods, they were up, they were looking at the whole scene, wondering what was going on. Because when Krishna had gone in, they had thought, oh, alas, Krishna will be killed. Oh, calamity, what tragedy. So they were watching this whole scene. And then they saw this Atma just floating up in the air, and they're wondering, what's going to happen next?
And Krishna when came out.
Then Krishna he came out.
No,
he opened his mouth.
Oh, Krishna opened the mouth of Agasura.
And all off.
He revived the cowherd boys and the calves. And then they walked out.
Krishna came.
And then when Krishna came,
at once that
the Atma that was hovering in the sky then went and merged into the body of Krishna.
No, in his feet.
His feet. It's all not, this is not in Krishna book all this. So then it's explained that how fortunate this Agasura was, that though a demon, but still he achieved Bhagavad, the Atma merged into his foot. So anyway, I won't say that. So then what happened next?
Can you tell after this something? You know some stutis of Brahma?
My apologies. Panchakalpa Thirubhishcha.
So try to remember something more.
So, when Krishna, he came out from the mouth of Agasura, and Agasura had been relieved of all of his, someone will say Krishna has killed him. No, Krishna has destroyed all his false ego, or his sinful body, and liberated that Atma. So seeing this, all the demigods, they became overjoyed. They began to beat drums, and dance, and chant, and shower flowers on Krishna. So at that time, Brahmaji, the creator of this universe, the highest of all the demigods, he was moving in the sky there on his swan carrier. And he was thinking, oh, what's going on? What is all this celebration about? And he came and he saw the Atma of Agasura enter into the lotus feet of Krishna. At that time, he was very
astonished. What became?
He was very astonished.
What became? Of Agasura Atma, what became?
Yes, sir.
Tell all these things.
Oh, the yes or no? Then yes or go and tell.
But he knows all the prayers, so I was waiting for that.
But he should know the essence and Siddhant. Or only it can be learned in association of high class of Krishna, realized soul. Otherwise, no. We can remember the slokas and so many things, but those some things are to be associate and to hear.
So, Sola Bhagasura get liberation. What kind of sajijya or not sajijya? However, there is five kinds of mukti: sarupa, salokka, sasti, samipa, and sajijya. Among these five, devotee don't like sajijya mukti liberation.
What is the sajijya?
Sajijya means imagine Brahma. It's called sajijya.
What happens there?
There, just like during operation theater, the patient has no sense. He don't know what is going on. Similarly, in sajijya mukti, soul couldn't understand that he is there or not. What is going on is just like a like stone. There is no realization of his soul. And there is no action in his soul. So he gave sarupa mukti. Seeing this,
what is sarupa mukti?
Sarupa means same form like Bhagavan, but not same like from associates of Bhagavan, same form of like his associate.
A shape like
associates
Narayan. Like Narayan.
400.
But not like Krishna. Some similarity will be there.
Yes.
And what is Samipya?
Samipya means near.
Anyone who is liberated. And he receives Samipa, he goes very nearer to Krishna, in a very nearer lok, or in a lok like Vaikunth. And there is also a Shasti. Shasti means like same opulence like Krishna, but not same. Like same, but not same. Not so much, very little. Why Vaishnava don't take these four Shaijimukti? They never take. The enemies of Krishna are Ramachandra, killed by them.
Killed by Bhagavan, they get that kind of liberation.
That kind of liberation. What?
Shaijimukti.
So, and also the devotees like, in first case of Sukadeva Goswami, they also have
some attraction.
This is also so high class, but Vaishnava don't hate
them. Upinagrinanti vinamat sevanam jana.
Also, they don't want Samipya, Sarupya.
Sarupya.
So Krishna, anyhow, mercifully gave him Sarupya Mukti. Like Narayan, any shape, nearer to any Lord. But Vaishnava don't want. Seeing this, oh, how rare is this Mukti. Even so, Brahmavadi, they don't have this. He has easily killed by Krishna and he has received. So he was thinking about this. Then he knew that, oh, he is supreme personality of Godhead. He is not demigod or anything. I want to see him some
more pastimes.
Then
Brahma don't somebody, they say that Brahma want to test, but no. Brahma being our Purvacharya, he could not keep this conception in his mind that I shall test him. No. He want to see more pastimes by his own effort. Why? Because Jogmaya attracts Brahma. Because in Braj, Krishna used to go for, during milking time, then all cows, they used to think, oh, if Krishna will be our cow, then I shall give her milk.
We will give milk.
We will give milk.
And he will be my son.
And he will be our cow. And all Sakhis of Mother Yashoda, they are thinking, oh, if Krishna will be our son, it will be very good fortune for us. Because on the way back from cow grazing, all Yashoda's Sakhis, they used to take Krishna in their lap, one after another. After that, Mother Yashoda, taking Krishna, went to his own residence. So they are thinking, oh, we can, he used to take Krishna only for a moment. But Mother Yashoda is so fortunate, he used to sleep with Krishna, he nourished Krishna always. So if Krishna will be our son, then we can nourish Krishna like Yashoda. Then it will be our very good fortune. Now all Prajagopis,
who
is teenage, they are thinking, yeah, oh, Krishna will be our husband. Then
Krishna is so,
so beautiful,
sweet, beautiful,
so sweet, so attractive,
so strong.
If
so
Krishna,
we want that Krishna should be our husband. So Krishna knew all.
Teenage years.
Yes.
Those who were not married.
Like
young.
Yes, like
young, not young.
Age like Krishna's age.
Like Pogan.
Yes.
So like in India, little babies, they took some pots full of water and they go to Shankar and they do Abhishek and oh, we want very beautiful husbands. Though they are not mature, even they. So that
So Krishna can accomplish so many things with so many tasks with his one action. So Krishna ordered Jogmaya. Then Jogmaya?
No, not ordered, but he wished.
He wished.
And Jogmaya at once came and wanted to
fulfill Krishna's desires. So Brahma came and he.
So Jogmaya inspired in Brahma.
Jogmaya inspired in Brahma, then Brahma stole his all cups. At first, Krishna was taking their meal under one tree, and cows are grazing nearby. Then Brahma stolen away the all calves and hide it near Tapovan in the bank of Jamuna. Also, because they are thinking, where is our calves? They could not find. Then Krishna told, wait a little bit, I shall find out all of them. If not, I shall play on flute, then all calves will come. So first thing, no, then you can see it, we are going. So they also went away, and leaving Krishna, they went for searching calves. Then Brahma,
they were sitting there. Krishna told them, you cannot search. And quickly I will search. So Krishna told them that you should take meals, and I'm just coming very soon.
Krishna asked them, sit here.
When?
And when Krishna went for searching, then Brahma came and
quickly take
all cowherd boys and hide them in same place. Then Krishna came and thinking,
searching.
What happened? No calves, no cowherd boys. When I shall go back, how I shall reply? At that day, it was birth star of birth constellation of Baladev Prabhu. He was not present at that day. He was thinking, all mothers will ask me, oh Kanha, you came alone, where is my son? How I shall reply then? Due to Naralila, he became so surprised and his body, his face became dry. Is in hand, there is some foodstuff of rice and some people. He forget to eat it. He is searching here and there. Then, with help of Jogmaya, he knew this fact that Brahma stolen away everything from here. So Krishna, then Brahma keeping them in cave, then in a bank of Jamuna, went to Brahmalok. When he entered to Brahmalok, Krishna became Brahma by his own form and ordered his servant that somebody want to cheat me, he is coming.
Cheat you all.
He want to cheat you all. He is coming like my own form, four-headed. Be careful. Don't be cheated by that.
Don't let him come here.
Imposter.
Don't let him come here. When Brahma is entering, because he is entering his own residence, no need to ask anyone. He is watching, watchman told, don't enter.
Brahma said, who are you?
Who are you? Brahma told, are you mad? No, no, we are not mad, you are mad. If you advance, we shall break your leg. Brahma said, what is going to happen? Any other day they never insult me, they are insulting me or they want to beat me. And Brahma became surprised. He came back and meditated. Oh, he saw his Krishna himself. Then he became sorry and come back again to Braj.
He returned to Braj.
And he saw Krishna is grazing cows, grazing calves with his cowherd's boys.
With all cowherds.
We are all cowherd boys.
Here and there playing.
Here and there playing. There is nothing that have nothing happened. Then rub his eyes and saw all calves, all cowherd boys become four-headed. Why? Because personal deity of Brahma is Garbhodak Sai Vishnu, four-handed. So Krishna want to show Brahma that what to say about me. That Krishna is Supreme Personality Godhead, but his calves, his cowherd boys, stick, their claws, not less than Garuda Sai Vishnu. They are all are transcendental. Then Brahma is doing pranam again and again. And now he is praying to Krishna.
Now again, when again, he saw that Krishna is
alone and searching his calves and cowherd boys.
And very sad. Then he began to pray. And oh, you are Supreme Personality of God. I could not understand you. And then he began to
pray.
What?
No mithate yavra bhagushe tadidambaraya gunjavatamsa paripichalasanumukhaya vannasraje kavalavetra visanavenu lakshmasriye mridupade pasupangajaya. Our Pugacharya Brahma is telling pasupangajaya. Brahma is telling that he is son of Nanda Baba. How he can say that he is son of Nanda Baba with this, by this law? Pasupangajaya. Pasupa. Pasupa means who take care of cows is Pasupa. And who took birth from him, who take birth from him is Pasupangajaya. That means Pasupa is Nanda Baba. Who came from Nanda Baba is Krishna. Naumidhate Abhrabhavuse. Brahma is telling him, go down this lotus feet. Who is this? Naumidhate Abhrabhavuse. He is body like new cloud. Tolidambaraya. Just like in cloud there is lightning. He is Pitambar just like lightning in his on his body. That is in cloud lightning. Krishna's body like new cloud and his Pitambar like lightning.
Pitambar means
the front cloud.
All this.
Chadar.
It's like Vidyut. Like thunderbolt.
Gunya Patansa Paripiccha Lasan Mukhaya. What is his decoration? What is his ornament? Gunja Patansa. One kind of fruit.
Oh, Gunja is another thing, avatans is another thing, not both are same. Gunja here, avatans means
here,
what thing?
Earrings,
so beautiful, of flowers.
Paripiccha lasan mukhaya, and on head, that is paripiccha means peacock feather. Vannasraje kavalavetra visana venu is decorated. His whole body top to bottom with worldly flowers who produced in jungle automatically. Kavalavitra Visana Venu, innocent foodstuff and stick for cow grazing and fruit, kefir. Lakshma.
Kefir means? Kefir, what is the meaning of?
He kept his fruit here. Kavalavatra Visana, Lakshma Sriye Mridupade Pasupanga Jaya. Pasupanga Jaya.
What is Lakshma Sriye?
Lakshma Sriye means and so many good symbols on his feet.
Where?
So, auspicious mark under his soul. And
what was there?
Like Dhaja, Vajra, Ankus, Pataka. Chariot, colors, fish, so many things. So he is moving here and there, all marks are coming on earth.
Mridupade.
Mridupade means slowly is moving.
Slowly and slowly. Like elephant boy. Very beautiful walk.
Became careless, he's walking freely and very slowly and slowly.
Smilingly. So I know it.
I go down in your lotus feet.
Any slope, you know? Gyani prayas mat
parshan.
Then one week, mukha
sacha. Brahmaji,
he
climbed down from his one carrier and fell again and again, offering his pranam to Krishna, and in a faltering voice, with his hair standing on end and tears flowing from his eight eyes, he began to offer so many prayers, such as this beautiful prayer.
What he saw, Krishna, like Naumidhate Abhrabhavan. What? He was taking something?
He saw Krishna, how he was standing like an ordinary boy holding some prasad remnants in his left hand, some fruit, some yogurt, some rice.
And
it is dripping through his fingers. So Ramaji began to offer prayer. Gyane praya samudapasana manta eva jivanti sammukaritam bhavadiya vartam stane stita asritikatam tanovan manove ye praya so dita didopya sitaistu lokyam. Ramaji is saying, Gyane prayasam, that the endeavor for knowledge, udapasya, it should be given up. And amanta eva, and rather one should just do pranam to Krishna. And jivanti san mukaritam bhavadiya vartam.
Gyane prayasam udapasya.
Gyane prayasam means the endeavor to acquire knowledge about Krishna, about the absolute truth, and also the knowledge of Krishna's opulence. That the knowledge of Krishna's opulence, it is an obstacle, a stumbling block for those who want to enter into the sweetness of Vrindavan. Krishna has said, Aishwarya Gyaneti Sabha Jagat Mishrita Aishwarya Shitila Prema Nahimura Prita. In this whole universe, everyone has the Aishwarya Gyan. They know me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But love which is made feeble by this Aishwarya Gyan is not satisfying to me.
Can we explain here Nirvishesh Gyan?
Nirvishesh Gyan, yes. And also the Brahma Jiva Aikya Gyan, the knowledge of Nirvishesh Gyan, of Brahma, thinking that the absolute truth is formless, impersonal, with no qualities, with no pastimes, no abode, no associates, no activities. This here, it should be rejected.
Here, not this means.
It means Aishwarya.
They are aparadhi, offensive in Krishna Lord's feet. So here it is not told. Only Jnan Misha Bhakti here, thinking that Krishna is Supreme Personality of God. He is Narayan, like this. This is also to be stopped.
So, then one may say, if we give up this knowledge of the opulence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then how will we understand anything? So Brahmaji, he's giving the actual suggestion. What is that? Jivanti san mukaritam bhavidya vartam. That one should hear the sweet pastimes of Krishna. From where?
So here.
San mukaritam.
Oh, Sada Puja. You should be one Puj. One point. Otherwise, if you are short here, there, over, you cannot. So, we will cut your
four.
And you will give only two.
So he said, what will we do? How will we understand anything? Jivanti san mukaritam bhavadiya vartam. One should hear the descriptions of Krishna's sweet pastimes. Where? San mukaritam, that means not from any tape, not from any book, not from any video or on any folio or internet or database. No. Jivanti san mukaritam. You have to hear these things from the mouth, from the lips of Sat, the
tape
pure devotee.
Tape will not do. Or anything will not do.
So then he said, Stane stita asritikatan tanovan manovir ye praya so dita didopya sitaistilokyam. Stane stita, this has different meanings. One meaning is, stay where you are. There is no need to make any external arrangement or change anything. If you are brahmachari, then remain brahmachari. If you are in grihastha ashram, then stay in grihastha ashram. If you are vanaprastha sannyas, then stay in that ashram. No need to make any external arrangement. But subject yourself to the flow of nectar coming out from the mouth of any pure Vaishnav. And the second meaning, stane stita, means, one meaning is stay where you are, meaning stay in your ashram. And the other meaning is that place where there is a sadhu speaking the sweet pastimes of Krishna, sweet Harikatamrita, then stay in that place and never leave that place. Always hear constantly the Harikata from the lips of a pure Vaishnava. Then?
What doing there?
Stane stita, sutigatan, tano van manobhir. And not only hearing for enjoyment, but actually tanum van manobhya, completely surrendering one's body, mind, and words to that sadhu. Then the Harikatha will enter into the heart.
Again. Doing pranam to that place. Doing pranam to who is telling Harikatha. Doing pranam to Srimad Bhagavatam, what he is reading. And doing pranam to who has managed,
arrange
everything. Those who have managed, a Vaishnava should come and tell Bhagavatam. And he has invited all Vaishnavas. They have made an arrangement of prasadam. Anyone is making arrangement of
mats
and shakranji. Anyone is brahmin. So all doing pranam to all by whole body and mind. Oh, how I'm lucky that I'm hearing Harikatha. To do pranam also by heart and by mind also, and giving respect to all, especially those who is speaking Harikatha. Like whom? Like Baldev Prabhu, like Guru, like Parikshit Maharaj have so much faith, so much honor, and so much trust in Sukadeva Goswami. So likewise. So if is anyone doing like this, thane sthita tanvang manobhi prayasu ajito api jita.
So then the question may come in the mind, if I give up the proper knowledge and all of these things, how will I control my mind? How will it be? So one should not fear about this. Ramaji is saying, "Ye prayasa jita jito taipyasi taistulokyam," that the many sages and yogis, they endeavor so hard to control their mind and senses. But for one who hears the sweet Harikatha, what to speak?
Control Krishna. So mind is very insignificant. They don't want to control mind. They want to control
Krishna.
The Krishna is never controlled by anyone. Whom? Those who are sharing Harikatha like this. Krishna is very soon is controlled. And gradually, sadhana bhakti, bhava bhakti, and prema bhakti comes. And thus his life becomes successful.
Then
what?
So, the simply by hearing the Harikatha, what to speak of controlling the mind very easily. Krishna becomes under control.
Don't have so much faith on reading. Everything is locked. Ja Bhagavat padha,
Vaishnava vyavastha
na. Oh, yeah. I will read myself and I will be Paramahans. You cannot understand a word even. So if the Vaishnava is bona fide, Guru is bona fide, and he knows all these things, then he can open Srimad Bhagavat lock and key. And then you can know, realize something. Otherwise, by your mind, by your intelligence, by your reading, by grammar and so on, anuswar, visarga, you cannot, and you will fall down. So we should hear from Vaishnavas. Then,
so by hearing the Harikatha, then Krishna, he becomes.
What became?
Under
what
control.
Become? Krishna will come by hearing in the shape of words, Harikatha, in heart. And then we clear all kinds of doubts, all kinds of anartha, offenses and everything, and his heart will be so pure and very smooth. And Krishna will make him realize that everything in bhakti will come. This is the process. Tasmin mahan mukharitam. So you should try to hear from wisdom. Qualified person, and if there is lacking of that thing, then you can read. But it will be better that when again Vaishnava will come, yes, you will hear. I think you have read Srimad Bhagavatam so many times, but as we are explaining, you have never heard anything like this. Never. In lakhs and lakhs, but you will not be qualified to know all these things. We have heard from our Gurudev, so many Vaishnavas. With Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Jiva Goswami. And then we have something very little, as a stone on the bank of endless ocean. Now it is 7 and 8. So we will explain some other shlokas tomorrow or other story. Go, Prama. Try to know. Here and to take it in our heart. When you should go from here, you should try to remember all this. What Maharaj has told, what Gurudev has told, what Vaishnava has told. And then remembering, you should sleep down. And in sleep you then see that all the thoughts are from. And if you are not going, then you are going from here and coming everything, we are keeping here everything and remembering worldly things and you will get then no good. Gaur Pramana. Where is Krishna Dasa? From tomorrow we will begin to move from here. Oh, here all the days were so much good, so much pure days. And you have so much lucky to hear so many Harikatha. More than Vaikunth. So, from tomorrow, quickly, gradually, they will leave this place and will go to other countries. Singapore. From Singapore to Bali, Australia, so many. I invite you all. What about tomorrow?
There is a program still.
Evening at what time?
Normal time. As now, starting at 5 o'clock.
I think that Govinda Bhagat and Prem Prayojan should go and manage for that. Where?
Tomorrow is a program here. All the persons who are coming from India, that group was blind, they have been invited.
They will come here.
And do
no,
performance.
They
are
not to go outside.
Here? Yes.
Oh,
then here we can. Like Delhi classes.
I don't know.
Then we go. Nothing to go anywhere else. No. Oh, hey.
Kahune mero sham de.
Hey, Kapoor ji se jara sab kirtan karte. राधे जय माधव देवी वैष्णव
जय राम